हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करज की और किड चैनल। आई एम वीना टीचर टीचिंग यू फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड मैथ सब्जेक्ट। सो व्हाट वी हैव सॉल्वड इन अवर लास्ट सेशन स्टूडेंट्स, यस वी हैव सॉल्वड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस विद डिफरेंट डिनोमिनेटर्स। आई होप यू ऑल हैव कंप्लीटेड योर होम असाइनमेंट। सम एग्जाम्पल्स आई हैव सॉल्वड ऑन द बोर्ड, रिमेनिंग एग्जाम्पल आई आस्क्ड यू टू सॉल्व इन रब बुक। सो ऑन पेज नंबर 21 दे हैड गिवन, while solving the subtraction with the different denominators where you can commit the mistakes. So let me explain about this. So three students solved the subtraction 4 upon 5 minus 1 upon 4 has shown. Which is the correct answer? Can you point out the mistakes in the wrong answer? So let's see the first example. First students, how we solved 4 upon 5 minus 1 upon 4. So denominators are not same. So we have to find out the LCM of the denominators. So what is the shortcut? 5 4s are 20. Correct. Then cross multiplication, 4 4s are 16 and 1 5s are 5. Correct. Denominators are same. So no need to. Then what we have to do? We have to subtract numerators. 16 minus 5 is 11. But denominator we supposed to write as it is. But what he have done? He have subtracted denominator also. 20 minus 20 is 0. Is it correct? No. So when the denominators are same, you have to write only once as it is. So here we have committed mistake. So this is wrong. Now let's see the second one. 4 upon 5 minus 1 upon 4. Now 5 4s are 20, denominator LCM is 20, then cross multiplication, 4 4s are 16, 1 5s are 5. Now we got same denominators, so we can subtract the numerators. 16 minus 5 is 11, 20 write only once. So 11 upon 20 is correct, isn't it? Now let's see the third student, what he have done. 4 upon 5 minus 1 upon 4. 4 minus 1, 3, 5 minus 4, 1. This is totally wrong. Why? When you can subtract directly with the fractions number, when the denominators are same, you can subtract the numerators. We cannot subtract the denominators. We have to make denominators same, then we have to go for the subtractions of numerator. That's why the students also have done wrong. So this mistakes you should not do while solving the fractions subtraction. That's why they had given. I hope you all are clear with this concept. Now let's move to the next term, story sums. Now today we are going to see the story sums of fractions. Now they had given first example. Let me explain you. See, what is the question? Raj bought a pen for rupees 25, 1 upon 2, and a notebook for rupees 20, 1 upon 4. How much money did he spend? So what they are saying? Raj, one boy, he bought one pen for rupees 25 and half. You can say half or 1 upon 2. And one notebook for 20, 1 by 4 or 1 upon 4. The cost of pen is 20, 1 upon 2, and the cost of notebook is 20 rupees, 1 by 4. So how much money did he spend? Now tell me students, what we have to do? Yes, he went to shop and he bought these two things. So what they are asking, how much money did he spend? So total how much money he has spent on pen as well as for the notebook. So what you will do? Yes, tell me what you will do. Of course we have to add. If you are buying two things from one shop, then what you will do? You will add both the things amount addition. Then you will do the calculation and you will give that amount to the shopkeeper, isn't it? So first you have to write the given information. What is the given information? Cost of pen, they had given rupees 20 25 1 upon 2. And the cost of notebook also they had given rupees 20 1 upon 4. Now we have to find out how much money did he spend in all. So total amount is equals to what we supposed to do? We have to add this both the numbers. So here I have written. Now see, you can see this is mixed fraction, isn't it? They had given in the mixed fractions. So what I do, we have to take whole numbers together and fractions in different way. Okay, first we will add whole number 25 rupees and 20 rupees, then we will add both the fractions. So you can see in this step we have taken separately whole numbers 25 plus 20 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 4. Now addition of 25 and 20 is 45. Now addition of 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 4, see here, 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 4. Now denominators are not same, so we have to find out the LCM of this both the numbers. I will find out here. See, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Now the next 2, 1 has it is 2 1s are 1. So what are the multiples of 2 and 4? Are 2 2s are 4. Now first 1 upon 2 is equals to, the denominator should come 4 because the LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. So what we have to multiply with 2, so we will get 4. 2 2s are 4, so here also 2. So 1 has it is 2 1s are 2. Next 1 upon 4 is equals to, denominator should come 4. So 4 multiplied by 1, 4 1s are 4. So 1 here also same, 1 1s are 1. So now 2 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. Now you can see denominators are same, so we can add the numerators. 2 plus 1 is 3 upon 4. So the addition of 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 4 is 3 upon 4. Now you can see the answer is, final answer is rupees 45, 3 upon 4 money he has spent in all. Clear? Clear till here? Yes, very good. Now I'll explain one more example. See the second question. Mohan reaches school in a school bus in 3 upon 8 hours. He walked to school in 3 upon 4 hours. How much more time does it take him to walk to school than to go by bus? So what they have given, that one boy is there, Mohan. So he goes to school every day by bus. So from his home to school, how much time he spent in bus? How much hours it takes? 3 upon 8 hours. So he walks to school. So when he missed the bus, if he want to come to school, it takes 3 upon 4 hours. So what we have to find out, how much more time does it take him to walk to school than go by bus? So we have to compare how much time it takes for school and it takes for bus and for walking. What is the difference? So for this, what you have to do, students, we have to subtract, isn't it? So if suppose I will give you example in this question they had given in fractions. If I give you example, Mohan reaches to school by in school bus in 2 hours, and suppose if he come by walking, it takes 4 hours. So how much time more he takes? Yes, for walking. So what you will do? Immediately you will subtract 4 minus 2. 4 hours minus 2 hours. So 2 hours more he need extra while coming by walking. Isn't it? So in the same way we have to find out in the fractions. Now see, what is the given information? Time taken to walk to school. How much time he takes? 3 upon 4 hours. And time taken by bus, when he comes by bus, it takes 3 upon 8 hours. So we have to find out the difference between both the hours. So 3 upon 4 minus 3 upon 8. Now denominators are not same, so what we have to do students, we have to find out the LCM of both the numbers 4 and 8. Okay, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, so 1 has it is 2 1s are 2. So what are the multiples of 4 and 8? 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. So what is the LCM of 4 and 8? It is 8. Now 3 upon 4. See, I'll do your rough work. 3 upon 4 is equals to, denominator should come 8. So we have to multiply with 2. 4 2s are 8. And 3 2s are 6. And the next is 3 upon 8. So denominator should come 8, means we have to multiply with 1. So 8 1s are 8, 3 1s are 3. So the numbers are 6 upon 8 and 3 upon 8. Now denominators are same, so we can subtract. See, 6 upon 8 and 3 upon 8. Now denominators are same, so write only once. 6 minus 3 is 3 upon 8. So how many hours difference? What is the difference? 3 upon 8 hours. Clear till here? Yes. Clear? Yes. Very good. Now we will start our exercise 1.13. Okay. Now what is the first question, students? Yes. Tell me. Exactly. We have to subtract from how much kilometer he used to take every day and how much kilometer he had gone when his cycle tire got punctured. Okay, first we have to write the given information. What they had given? See, Ravi's school is 2.5 kilometer from his house. Distance from house to school, how much it is? 2.5 kilometer. Okay, and the next, what they had given? So one day when his tire got punctured, how much he covered? Distance covered by cycle, how much he covered? Distance covered by cycle is equals to 1 1/4 kilometer. So what we have to find out in this question, what distance did he have to walk? So distance he walked, or else you can write distance covered by walking, or distance he have to walk, we have to find out, isn't it? So what we have to do, we have to subtract. 2 1 upon 2 minus 1 1 upon 4. Now see in this question, students, now mixed fraction is there. So what we will do first, denominators are not same, so we cannot subtract. We have to find out the LCM. Now whole numbers we will take together. 2 minus minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1. Now we will take together fractions this side. Now see, what are the fractions? 1 upon 2 minus 1 upon 4. Now denominators are not same, so find out the LCM of 2 and 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Again, 1 has it is 2 1s are 2. So what are the multiples of 2 and 4? Is 2 multiplied by 2 is 4. So here 1 upon 2 is equals to, the denominator should come 4. So 2 multiplied by 2, 2 2s are 4. So here also 2, 1 2s are 2. 1 upon 4 is equals to, denominator should come 4. So here also 4, 1s are 4. Here also multiply by 1, 1 1s are 1. Now we got both the denominators are same, so we can subtract. So 2 upon 4 minus 1 upon 4. So denominator write once. 2 minus 1 is 1 upon 4. And the whole number is 1. So here the answer is 1 upon 4. How much distance we have to walk? 1 kilometer and 1/4. So total distance he walked, you have to write here answer. Total distance he walked 1 kilometer, 1/4 kilometer. Understood? Clear? Yes. Is that clear? Tell me. Yes, very good. Now we will move to the next question. Now second one, Arun wants to buy a marker. What do you want to buy? Marker. So he has ₹3.5. His father gives him ₹5.14. How much money does he have now? So what do you want to buy? He want to buy a marker, isn't it? So for that, how much money his father has given him? ₹5.14. So how much money does he have now? Already he is having money and his father also given. So what we have to do in this case? Yes, tell me. Yes, students, tell me. Yes, exactly. He is having some money and father also given. So we have to add together. So they are asking question, how much money does he have now? So what is the given information? Arun have ₹3.5 and his father gives him ₹5.14. Now how we have to find out how much money does he have now? Total money is equals to question mark. We have to find out. So we will add 3 1/2 plus 5 1/4. Now here both the numbers are mixed fractions. So what I'll do first, we will add whole number together. Okay? Then we will add fractions together. Now I will separate the whole numbers. 3 plus 5 is 8. Now next, I will take fractions 1/2 and 1/4. Now denominators are not same, so we have to find out the LCM of both the numbers. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. 1 has it is 2 ones are 2. So what are the multiples of 2 and 4? 2 multiplied by 2. So 2 twos are 4. So 1/2 is equals to, the denominator should come because the LCM of 2 and 4 is 4 only. So we have to multiply with 2 twos are 4. So here also 2, 1 has it is. 1 twos are 2. The next 1/4. The denominator should come 4. So 4 ones are 4. So here also 1, 1 has it is. 1 ones are 1. Now we got both the denominators are same. So now we can add both the numbers. Denominators are same, right ones. Numerators add together. 2 plus 1 is 3 upon 4. So here, what is the whole number? 8 and 3 upon 4. So what you will write? How much money does he have now? So Arun have rupees 8 3/4. Okay, clear till here? Yes. See, have, no, you have to write has. Arun has now rupees. Okay, clear? Yes. Now one more example I'll solve for you. Now see the eighth one. What is the question? A vessel had 3.5 liters of a milk. A cat drank 3/4 liters. So how much milk is left in the vessel? So what happened at home? Vessel means bowl, patela. Okay, we take milk where we see everyday milkman comes. So your mother takes milk. So she will take in vessel. So how much milk was there in the vessel? 3 liters, 3 1/2 means 3.5 liters of the milk. So what happened? Cat came in house and cat drank 3/4 liters of the milk. So how much milk is left in the vessel? So what do you have to do? Yes. What you will do? Tell me. Yes. Now suppose this is the fraction number. Now I'll give you simple number. Now you tell me the answer. Suppose imagine that 5 liter milk was there in the vessel and cat drank 2 liters from that vessel. So how much milk is left in the vessels? Yes, you all are saying teacher 3 liters. So what you have done here? Directly minus, isn't it? In the same way we have to subtract fraction numbers also. So first we will write what is the given information. A vessel had how much milk is there? A vessel had milk is equals to 3 1/2 liters and the given information next, a cat drank how much? 3/4 liters, isn't it? So what we have to find out? How much milk is left in vessel? Milk left in vessel is equals to question mark. So 3 1/2 minus 3/4, isn't it? So we have to find out this with the subtraction. Now here see, one is mixed fraction and one is has it is. So first what we have to do? Mixed fractions we will convert into improper fraction. Okay, this number 3 1/2 means what we have to do? 3 multiplied by 2 plus 1/2. 3 to the 6, 6 plus 1, 7/2. So the number is 7/2 minus 3/4. Now see, the denominators are not same. So what we have to do? We have to find out the LCM of both the numbers 2 and 4. Now see here, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 1 has it is, 2 ones are 2. So the multiples of 2 and 4 is 2, 2. So LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. Now what we have to do? we have to make denominators same of both the numbers. First is 7 upon 2. Denominator should come 4. So 2 2's are 4. So here also 2, write 7 as it is. 7 2's are 14. Now next, 3 upon 4. So what should come in the denominator? 4. So 4 1's are 4. So 1 here also, and write 3 as it is, then multiply. 3 1's are 3. Now we got both the denominators are same. So now we can subtract. 14 upon 4 minus 3 upon 4. Denominators are same, so we can subtract the numerators and write denominator once as it is. Now 14 minus 1 is what? Yes, come on, tell me. 14 minus 1 is, 3 is 11, isn't it? 11 upon 4. Now this is not final answer. Now see, we have to convert into, when question is given into the mixed fractions, you have to convert answer also into the mixed fraction. Now I will divide this number, 11 divided by 4. In 4 table 11 is there? No. 4 3's are, 4 1's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 4 3's are 12. No. We have to go with 2. 4 2's are 8. Now tell me subtraction, 11 minus 8. Count after 8 till 11 comes, 9, 10, 11. 3 will remain. So first we will write the quotient, that is 2, and the remainder in the place of numerator and the denominator as it is. Understood? Clear? So what you will write? Answer, 2, 3 upon 4 liters of milk left in vessel. Clear till here? Understood, students? Very good. Now see, I have solved 3 examples of exercise 1.13. Now remaining all examples are same like these examples, only addition and subtraction. Now today's your home assignment is practice all the sums in your rap book. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me in a Google Meet. Okay, now today we have completed our first chapter, that is fractions. So practice all exercise. Lesson is very big. Total 13 exercises are there, 1.1 to 1.13. So practice daily one exercise and two examples of each exercise. So in our next session, I am going to start our new chapter. Till that time, bye bye, take care and thank you.